future of the U.S. Senate is at stake as Georgia voters head to the polls, where they'll cast ballots in two key runoff elections. President Trump and President-elect Joe Biden held dueling rallies for the candidates yesterday. Mr. Biden is banking on Democrats winning both races so that he can forge ahead with his top legislative priorities, while Republicans hope to maintain control of the upper chamber. Senator David Perdue is facing off against John Ossoff, and Senator Kelly Loeffler is up against Reverend Raphael Warnock. So for more on this, let us bring in CBSN political reporter Caitlin Huey-Burns. She is with us now from Atlanta. Caitlin, can you take us through the latest developments there? What are the voting numbers looking like right now? How do they compare to what we saw in November?
Hi, good morning. Well, we're at a polling place in Atlanta. There's a DJ here. Lots of people had come earlier in the morning. I know a lot of people have kind of been comparing this to an overtime election. We've been saying on the ground here that it's a new year, but an old election. So 2020 is finally coming to an end today here in Georgia with these two runoff races. A couple of numbers to keep in mind. About 3 million people have already cast their ballots in this election. About 2 million of those ballots were cast in person, about a million by mail. There could be as many as 4 million people voting in this runoff race, which would be historic for a runoff where we traditionally see those numbers drop. In the general election here in Georgia, there were about 5 million voters, and that set a record for the state. And remember, that margin that Biden won in the general election was about 12,000 votes. And so that kind of shows how close races can be here. A couple of notes, too, from our amazing polling unit as they've been looking at the ballots that have been returned. A couple of things to keep in mind for both parties. First, for Democrats, they've seen an uptick in black voters voting early from November. For Republicans, something that may help them is that they've seen an uptick in senior voters since November voting early. Remember, we don't know how these voters cast their ballots because those numbers have not been tabulated, but it just shows the demographics and groups that these parties are targeting. And both campaigns have been trying to get people to vote early. Polls here are open until 7 p.m. today. You can vote in person here, obviously, but you can also drop off your absentee ballot if you hadn't turned it in already. There's a drop box here at this location. For example, about 400,000 absentee ballots are still left out there. So that goes to show kind of what they're expecting for today.
Caitlin, what's going to be the key for Democrats winning in Georgia, which, as you know, has long been a red state up until Biden's victory there in November? So how can Democrats actually clinch wins in these two races?
Well, the key for Democrats is trying to replicate the turnout that Biden got in November. And that's significant. That can be a big challenge. Even though Biden was successful, John Ossoff, for example, one of the Democrats running here in this runoff, came about 100,000 fewer votes than Joe Biden did. So that suggests that either there were people out there that voted for both Biden and Perdue, for example, or people voted for a Libertarian candidate, or people in November just didn't vote down ballot, even if they voted for Biden. So the key that Democrats have been trying to do is turn out new voters as well. And according to some numbers, there are about 100,000 people that have voted already who didn't vote in November. So Democrats see that as an encouraging sign. And the message that they want to send with these races, of course, they want to win both of them in order to gain control of the Senate with Kamala Harris as the tiebreaker. But they want to send a message that Biden's win wasn't just a one-off, that Democrats have been advancing in the state. We'll see what the numbers ultimately say.
So, Caitlin, as Vlad pointed out, the state, Georgia, has been a red state for some time now. The president's movement, his populist movement, if you will, has a major following there and a lot of support. He certainly had a pretty decent rally with Kelly Loeffler. So is that enough, though? I mean, will Republican voters not only see themselves going to the polls for their two current senators, but also in defense of President Trump, who, as we know, has over the past several weeks been sort of railing against the electoral process in Georgia in particular?
Right, and that's causing a lot of hurdles for Republicans running in these races. You have the president undermining the results, but also saying to voters, as he did last night, if you are mad about what happened, turn out in these races. Republicans, however, here do not want to show any daylight between themselves and the president, even as he says controversial and unfounded claims, because they need his voters to show up for them today. Republicans have been encouraging people to vote early and to vote absentee, but they also are banking on heavy in-person election day turnout to make up that gap. They know this race is close, but they need Trump's supporters to support them as well. And so that's why you haven't seen David Perdue or Kelly Loeffler say anything negative about the president. In fact, they've come to his defense. They have been very critical of the Secretary of State here, Republican Brad Raffensperger. They even called on him to resign several weeks ago. So that shows you kind of the political dynamics here. So they're hoping the president's rally last night did enough to encourage those voters that they need to show up for these down ballot races.
And Caitlin, when it comes to fundraising and ad spending, these races have generated a lot of money, tens of millions of dollars. What can you tell us about the money raised and what it means overall?
Well, unless you've been buried in a hole for the last several weeks, chances are you have seen more than a lifetime of ads here in Georgia. I mean, it is really difficult to watch a minute of television here without seeing ads for all of the candidates. So nearly $500 million is going to be spent on these runoffs at the end of the day. That goes to show how critical these races are for all involved. Really, the eyes of the nation are watching here in Georgia, and the money spent on these races reflects that. Voters that we've been talking to say that they are exhausted by this process, that they are ready for it to be over, but they're also excited to have Georgia in the spotlight, even if it means all of those ads that are flooding the airwaves here.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you about. You know, covering this race from a distance is one thing, but actually living in the state is completely different. And I'm wondering how voters are approaching this runoff election. Are they, you know, considering what these individual candidates will mean for their lives in Georgia, how they will improve the state? Or are they voting with a knowledge of, you know, the shift in the Senate that is possible and that the entire country is watching?
You know, Anne-Marie, we spent a lot of time here at the end of last year before the holidays and talking to voters then. It was really the latter. They knew on both sides how critical these races are in terms of the balance of power in the Senate and what it means for President-elect Biden's agenda. So Democrats have been saying that they want to vote for these two Democratic candidates so that Biden can hopefully, in their words, get things done. But for Republicans, it's a similar dynamic. They're hoping that Republicans can be successful so they can block the president-elect's agenda. And it's been really interesting talking to Republican voters. A lot of them have told us that they believe the president's rhetoric, those unfounded claims of voter fraud, but still they have told us that they are planning to vote or that they had already voted. And that's been a dynamic that we're watching here in the closing hours. Has the president's rhetoric done anything to discourage his own voters from participating? So that's something to watch, and that's why you've seen both sides really hammering home every last vote counts here in Georgia and has national implications. And both sides have also been saying that this will have a generational impact.
All right, we'll be watching all day long. Caitlin, thank you very much as always. Appreciate it.